In this video, we will take a look at discrete symmetries in quantum field theory. Many of you have probably learned about symmetry in school and forgotten all about it. To most people, it is just something you learn and forget, but in fundamental physics, symmetries play a very important and fundamental role in our theories describing the world. So in case you forgot what symmetries are, then I will make a quick recap shortly. As it turns out, in relation to the standard model, we consider three different discrete symmetries. We call these symmetries charge or C symmetry, parity or P symmetry, and time reversal or T symmetry. As we will see in this video, these symmetries are very important for the standard model. Let us start with the basics. What is symmetry? Symmetry is when the shape of the object is exactly the same after manipulating the object. A simple example would be to consider a triangle with two equal sides. This triangle has a symmetry line down the middle such that you can flip it or mirror it across the symmetry line and the triangle would look the same. This is a very simple example, but for today that is the level of understanding of symmetry which we need. But let us consider a slightly more complex example to make sure we all get it. We can consider a square. A square has four symmetry lines, two diagonally across the corners, one vertically and one horizontally. One can also consider other polygons with more symmetries or a circle with infinite symmetries. But let us get to C, P and T symmetry. Let us start with charge symmetry. This is probably the simplest one to discuss. As the name suggests, this symmetry has to do with the charge of the particle. This affects not only the electric charge, but also other charges which the particle can have, like color charge. Therefore, this symmetry leads to charge conjugation, thus all charges become the opposite. As you might know, antiparticles are particles where all the charges have the opposite sign compared to their particle counterpart. Thus, charge symmetry is all about symmetry between particles and antiparticles. Thus, if you do a charge conjugation transformation of a particle, you get an antiparticle. In principle, this symmetry ensures equality between matter and antimatter. But as we discovered in the 50s, this symmetry is broken by the weak force. Thus, while the strong and electromagnetic force respect charge symmetry, the weak force does not. We will discuss that a bit more shortly. The next symmetry is parity, which is a symmetry we humans can easily relate to. It's like looking at the mirror. Parity is related to changing the sign of one or more coordinates. This is what happens when you look at a mirror and see your mirror image is flipped. We call this flipping a parity transformation. A lot of objects in the universe are not affected by such a transformation, often because they are scalar quantities. Things like time, mass and energy are not affected by this spatial inversion. But other things like velocity and position is of course affected by parity transformations. Again, we find that the strong and electromagnetic force obeys parity symmetry, but the weak force does not. The point of this aforementioned experiment in the 50s was to test the parity of the weak force, and the results showed that the weak force broke both charge and parity symmetry. The experiment was done by looking at a beta minus decay, and they discovered that the involved electron preferred one direction over another. An analogy is to consider two clocks, where the second clock is constructed mirror to the first one. One would expect the normal clock to tick to the right, and likewise the mirrored clock would tick to the left if parity symmetry works. But in the case of this experiment, it was like if the mirror clock would tick to the right, like the original clock, and thus the mirror clock would not match the movement of the normal clock. One direction is preferred. This is the case of the weak force, and likewise, this also ruins charge symmetry. At this point, you might be thinking, okay, why are these symmetries so important if the weak force breaks everything anyway? The issue is very fundamental. The standard model is based on quantum field theory, and to make the story short, there is a theorem called the CPT theorem. And this basically states that for a physical quantum field theory to work, it must obey CPT symmetry. This means the symmetry of combining all these three symmetries thus combining charge, parity and time reversal symmetry. The easiest way to live up to the CPT symmetry would be if the standard model would obey every symmetry on its own. As we have discussed, the weak force likes to make a mess and it completely breaks C and P symmetry. The hope was that the CP symmetry would be respected by the standard model and also T symmetry, because generally standard models seem to obey time symmetry. The concept of CP symmetry lasted less than 10 years, and in 1964 the discovery of CP violation was discovered, again thanks to the weak force. Scientists looked at kaons, which are a type of mesons made from down and strange quarks, and then one of the quarks is an antiquark. The thing is that kaons can oscillate between being a particle and an antiparticle. Thus the quark switches role in which of them is the antiparticle. What they initially discovered was that this oscillation favored one type of kaon over the other. Thus in other words, matter or antimatter are not equal in CP violations. Direct evidence came many years later by studying the decay of kaons, and in more recent times CERN has found some other CP violating processes from other mesons. CP violation is very important in particle physics and cosmology. This is related to the Sakharov conditions. We basically only see regular matter in the universe, but if the world was such that matter and antimatter is created equally, then where is the antimatter? CP violation is key in explaining this question, and it can also allow matter to be preferred over antimatter. This brings us to CPT symmetry, because if we are to trust the standard model, then this symmetry is the last defense. If CP symmetry is broken, then this means that the time reversal symmetry must also be broken such that it cancels out the CP violation, such that CPT symmetry is intact. Time reversal or T symmetry is simply when the direction of time is flipped, which might be a bit counterintuitive to imagine, but generally Feynman diagrams can be reversed, thus T symmetry is generally conserved. So far, no one has been able to find CPT violations in the standard model, thus it is likely that indeed time reversal symmetry is indeed broken, such that it cancels out CP violation. Furthermore, while the weak force fully breaks C and P symmetry, it only seems to break CP violation partially, thus this requires that there is some small breaking of the time reversal symmetry. These discrete symmetries are very important for quantum field theory and help us classify theories, like the fact that a strong electromagnetic force is symmetric under all these symmetries individually. As we will discuss later, symmetry is also the foundation for something called group theory, which is possibly even more important in quantum field theory. In the next video, we will learn what a mathematical group is and how they are linked to symmetries, and then we will see that groups make up the structure of the standard model, and they explain a lot of why the standard model looks like it does and why it works like it does. I also hope you learned something interesting in this video. If you would like to support the channel, please use the link in the description. As always, if you have any questions, you can write them in the comment section. If you like the video, please like and subscribe for more videos to come. As always, stay tuned for the next video.